really after that Vanderbilt game at Vanderbilt is when things started to change a little bit. And the reason I bring that up is because of John Fulkerson, okay? Because John Fulkerson, we know what he has meant to this program, what he means to the program. But if you think about a sixth-year senior that said, you know what, I know right now I got to figure some things out. I got to find a way to get back to my best. And that's what he did when he said, you know what, maybe me not being in the starting lineup right now is the best thing for this team. I got to take a step back. I got to figure it out. I got to work. And Urosh went in the starting lineup. And when Urosh went in the starting lineup, it changed not only because of what Urosh did, but what John was able to do coming off the bench. And I just think it speaks to great humility of John Fulkerson that he has, more so, forget as a player, but as a person. And I think we all know the type of person he is. So that takes us as we're going. We're starting to find a little bit of a groove. Some of those instances that happened on the court at Vanderbilt, on the court at LSU, Florida, some of those on-court intensity moments obviously bring a team closer. But now you fast forward to South Carolina. We play really well. Olivier goes down with an injury. And the first thing that is brought up is John Fulkerson coming back into the starting lineup. That's the very first guy we think of as a coaching staff, because John is working every day. People don't see it, but 2-3 times a day he's going in the gym working, trying to reinvent himself, trying to find a new identity for himself for the rest of this season. Knowing the team player that he is, it means nothing to him about his individual game, but what can he do for the team to make us better as we get down the home stretch? So we go to John and we say, John, we're going to go back with you. And he goes through the shoot around normal in the starting lineup. And then after the shoot around, he comes up to the coaching staff and he says, you know what, coach? I think it's better if I keep coming off the bench. I think I found something. It's good for me. I get to see the game. And I think it's good for the other guys on the team that we can get someone else to get going by starting them. And it's going to make us better as a team. So again, another thing that just speaks volumes about John as a person, as a player, as a team member. So that's when Brandon gets an opportunity to step in there. And it just, right now we feel, again, we're going like this, and he's as big a reason as any. Because what he's doing every day, again, he's finding a way to be better. Not necessarily just for himself, but he's finding a way to help make this team better. He's allowing Brandon Huntley Hatfield to be better. He's allowing Jonas Adu to be better. And we all know what a great impact Jonas had last night. And you really look back to the Mississippi State game and the impact that Jonas made there. So whether or not John starts, doesn't start, plays 15 minutes, plays 30 minutes, has 14 points like he did last night, or 6 or 8 points like he did the other night versus Vanderbilt, his impact is incredible on this team, and it's incredible on this program, this community, and that's why he's such a special person. And lastly, we'll talk about John last night. 14 points, does what he does against potentially a national player of the year in Oscar Tshiebwe. Great player, great player. But John took that challenge, knowing that up in Lexington, you know, they got the better of us pretty good. And our guys remembered it, our team remembered it, the coaching staff remembered it, but John remembered that individual matchup, and he took that very personal, and he did a great job of it last night. So, and the fans remembered it, obviously, and they let Kentucky know about it from the tip. About an hour and a half before the tip, they started letting them know about it, which was great. So,
take a tour of Big Orange basketball history at the Hoops Museum in North Knoxville. This nonprofit collection preserves UT men's basketball memorabilia. Historian R. Larry Smith shares more than 100 years of Vols, including the Ray Mears era, to today's team. Displayed are dozens of vintage Tennessee artifacts. Hoops Museum tours are free. Just bring a game program, ticket stub, or sports page to help R. Larry Smith round out this historic tribute. Phone 865-679-4106 to plan your Hoops Museum visit.